Hello friends, this is Yogesh Muramkar. In this video, we are going to talk about procedures and functions. So basically, we are going to talk about this particular statement. Write and execute PL SQL store procedure and functions to perform a suitable task on the database and demonstrate its use. So what are stored procedures we are going to see, and then we are going to talk about what are the stored functions, procedures and functions. So let us start with functions. So MySQL stored functions provides a powerful and flexible way to manipulate and process data. You can define and store and run stored functions on any type of hosting server that uses MySQL. So and even you can set a database. So to demonstrate, we will see some examples. We will see following examples. The syntax to create a function is create a database is create database database name. So what we are going to do is we will create a database first, and then on the particular database we are going to create procedures and functions. So let us create a database with the command create database. So create database, for example, the database's name, let us say it is ypm underscore test. So create database ypm underscore test. So it is saying query OK. So it has created a database with the name ypm underscore test. So let us connect to that particular database by using command use. After creating database, now let us create a table products by using a command create table, which we have already seen in the previous videos of MySQL. So create table products with these columns: product ID, product name and price. If I try to describe products with the command describe, you can see there are four columns: product ID, name, cost and price. And it has also shown its data type or other details. Now let us insert some data into that particular table, that is products. So we are going to insert three records in that. It is inserted. Now you can check those records by using this command: select star from products table. So you can see product name, product cost and price, and three records are added. Now to create a function, this is the syntax. Create function we are using, and then begin and then end. So what this function is doing, it is calculating profit. So how it is calculating the profit? So set profit is equal to price minus cost. That is the only thing it has used. So I can use that particular cal profit function in my select query in this way. So this query is showing you how that particular function can be used. So basically, why we create procedures and functions, because whenever we need some particular thing to repeat again and again, at that time it is very useful to use functions and procedures. So this is how you can use that particular cal profit function into select query. So it is showing you one more column added as profit, and which has calculated the profit for each and every product in the products table. Now for example, I want to check which particular product has made how much profit, so that I can check also by using this particular command. So see, product name and profit, you can check it here. So this is all about functions. The difference between procedure and function is that you actually a procedure function returns something, some values, whereas procedure we need to call it by using a command called as call. So stored procedures are sometimes confused with stored functions, but they are different in some important ways. Stored procedures, for example, must be invoked with call statement, whereas stored functions can be used directly in SQL expressions. So now create a procedure with the command create procedure. The name of the procedure is procedure test. So now to call that particular procedure, just run this command call and procedure name. So it is going to display just the column names. The query which we have run, that is select product name from products. So it is going to show the output of that particular query. So instead of running that query again and again, what I can do is I can call that particular procedure. I can create a procedure on all the columns also. For example, I want to create a procedure for this query, select star from EMP. So I can do that here also. You will have to run this particular query, and so it will show you create procedure. Okay, in this case it might not display you the output of this particular procedure, because we will not have EMP table in our database. So it might not show you the result of this call and procedure name because we do not have EMP table here, that's why. But I have just shown you one more example how you can create. Yeah, it is not showing because EMP table does not exist in the database ypm underscore test. That's why it is not showing you any output for this particular command. Otherwise it is the same way earlier we have created a procedure. So the reason is we do not have emp table. That's why we are not able to see the result for that particular query. Okay, otherwise it is very simple to create the procedure. Okay, so this is all about procedures and functions, and they are used for repetitive tasks. Difference between them is function returns, procedure not. Thank you.